here. But if I may get back to some quotes from the Jews concerning the New World Order, and I'd like to also put a video up on this particular episode to show so you can see with your eyes, okay, the quotes coming from the Jews themselves. Now, again, reminding you, these are not Eric's words. These are from the Jews themselves who are behind the New World Order, that this is what they teach. This is what they believe. again, as Christopher mentioned, coming from the Talmud. And so I know there's a misconception when we say the word Jew. Again, we have to understand this is not race based. This is based upon someone's belief system. Okay, it's we're not targeting, you know, Polish people. We're not targeting Russians. We're not targeting Jews in that sense. We're targeting ideologies. We're targeting a belief system. Okay, and so what we have to understand is that the Jews admit that through the Second World War, the Zionist state of Israel was set up. And here's where most of your individuals go astray, especially the Protestants. I mean, I can't tell you how. I mean, it's just taught amongst the fundamentalists and the various Protestant sects that, you know, Israel in the Old Testament is the Israel you see now. Well, no, Israel was a foreshadowing. Had they stayed in the Catholic Church and had they actually followed what Christ teaches through his Catholic Church, they would realize that Israel is a foreshadowing for God's true people, who is Catholics, who are Catholics. Okay, so, you know, this is a deception of our hour to where people are falling for this notion that, you know, the Jews have this right to this certain land, which if you read church tradition, if you read church history, you will see Pope after Pope banishing the Jews who taught literally they should wander the earth until they repent. They should wander the earth. They should have no place to stay. Okay, and again, that's Pope saying that. That's not Eric. And so I just kind of wanted to segue to a few quotes here, Christopher, and I'll try to get to maybe a few, and then we can maybe put the rest of them up on the screen, but just some more notable Jews. Pete Meyer states, Zionism is not only about a Jewish state, it's about a Jewish world order, quote unquote. Rabbi Harry Watton states, since the Jews are the highest and most cultured people on earth, the Jews have a right to subordinate to themselves the rest of mankind and to be masters over this whole earth. The Jews differ from all other races and people because of Judaism. Judaism differs from all other religions because of Jehovah, and Jehovah differs from all other gods. Judaism is communism, internationalism, the universal brotherhood of man, the emancipation of the working class, and of the human society. It is these spiritual weapons that the Jews will conquer the world and the human race. The races and the nations will cheerfully submit to the spiritual power of Judaism, and all will become Jews. That was Rabbi Harry Watton. We also have another prominent member from the Jewish Alliance, Israelite Universal. His name was John Juliet, I might be butchering the name, but he stated very briefly, the meaning of history in the last century is that today 300 Jewish financiers, all masters of Masonic lodges, rule the world. And that was back in 1931. He stated that they ruled the world. So think about that. We're nearly, about 75 years or so, give or take. And they ruled the world back then. We also have...